Hi everyone, welcome to the fourth video on Docker learning series for network engineers. In the previous video we have seen how to install all the required packages for running Ansible. In this video we will see how to run Ansible playbook and get configuration from Cisco device from container. I have installed one container in the last video. I'll show that. I'll give Docker ps. That container is not running now. I'll give ps-a. You can see the container name myubuntu. So let me start the container. Docker start myubuntu. You can see it started. Now let me attach to that Docker. Docker attach myubuntu. You can see here 172.17.0.1 is my host machine IP. I am able to reach from host machine. I'll verify the network connectivity first, network configuration. So the command is docker network inspect bridge. You can see the IP of this container 172.17.0.2. Let me try ping into that IP 172.17.0.2. I am able to reach from my host machine as well. Now we'll verify the packages we installed in the previous video. Yeah, you can see here all the required packages are there. Ansible 2.9.6 and Paramico, and all the other required libraries are there. You can even verify like this, Ansible --, version. Yeah, it is 2.9.6, and let's see the resource utilization. Docker stats. We can see it is using now 6 MB of memory. Now let's go to Ansible site. First we'll try running Ansible command without a playbook. You can see one command here. Regarding this, I have created another video, how to run Ansible commands and Ansible playbook. I'll add that video in the description and tag. Here you can see, instead of using inventory, I'm giving, here you can see, it uses all, and here we need to give device IP in our case. Then it is going to use network CLI, and I need to give username, and the OS is going to be iOS in our case, since it is Cisco device. I'll copy this. I have already framed command here, you can see. I'll paste it here for the comparison. In my case, device IP is 0.50 and username is admin, and here you can see network OS, Ansible network OS is iOS. Let me try running this. If you want, you can verify the connectivity to the device. It is 192.168.0.50. I am able to reach to the device. Let me try running this Ansible command. It is asking for password. Yeah, you can see the error message, unable to connect to port 22. By default, host key check will be enabled. We'll see that in the Ansible configuration, etc. Ansible and ansible.conf. Yeah, you can see here, uncomment this to disable SSH key host key checking. So by default host key checking is enabled. You need to give this. Now let's try the command again. Yeah, you can see here I'm able to contact the device and get the complete facts output of Ansible. Same script I have explained in another video. Now we'll see how to run a playbook. You can see here in my home Ansible backup folder I have a playbook. Now we need to copy this to our container. So for copying to container, you can see command reference of Docker. You can refer all the Docker commands here. You can see a command here, docker cp. So this copies files or folders between container and local file system. Now we'll use this command. We'll open a terminal here. Docker cp and I'll give the file name. Before that I'll create a folder here inside my container. Okay, you can see I'm into the direct root folder. Now I'll make a directory, Ansible files. You can see Ansible files is there now. I'll go to that folder, Ansible files. Now let me copy to that location. And I'll give the container name slash Ansible underscore files. Yeah, file has been copied. Now let's verify it here. Yeah, you can see file has been copied to my container. Now we'll see the command to execute that. We'll go to Ansible site. Here you can see a sample command. A simple command it is actually. This fetches the configuration of device. Here we need to give our device IP, username is admin, and OS is iOS, and we need to define the playbook name. Let's try running it. Before running it, we'll just have a look into this config, this playbook file. You can see it is using network CLI, username is admin, hardcoded here. Then it is trying to get the facts, iOS facts, and from the complete iOS facts it will filter hostname and image version, and it will print in this format. Hostname is the hostname of the device and OS is the operating system version. It will try printing that. Let's try running it. Yeah, I have received output from the device. You can see the device host name is CSR1 and operating system is 16701. Similar way, you can have any playbook running from this container. The advantage with container is if you want to have different versions of Ansible or different Pythons, if you want to test something from different pythons and all, you can have separate container for all that. Now if you want to see the resource utilization of this machine, you can see it is using 21 MB of memory. But we got the complete functionality of Ansible here. In the next video, we'll see Docker file. So you can see Docker file here. So Docker can build image by reading instruction from a text file, that is Docker file. In the previous video, we have seen we installed all the required packages after running the image, but actually we can simplify that process using Docker file. We'll see that in the next video. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.